Once the design of the character is finalized, the turnaround, or some people will call it turntable, is generated. Typically, the turnaround consists of the front, side, and back views of the character. The main purpose of this turnaround is to provide information for 3D modelers. Therefore, the drawings need to be accurate. And by accurate, I mean that they need to align themselves. For example, the size of the head on the front view should be the same as the size of the head on the side view. If your character has a prop or weapon, it is also useful to include that drawing together with the turnaround. This is, for one, to give additional information to the modelers, and it can also help to suggest the proportion of the prop in relation to the character. Additional drawings may be included to suggest the character's personality and how he or she should animate. These additional drawings can also showcase certain gameplay mechanics of the character. To ensure accuracy, I start by drawing some guidelines on a separate layer. I have one on the top of the head, one on the shoulders, two on the pelvis, and one at the bottom of the foot. You do not have to follow this strictly, but this works for the design that I have. The more lines you have, the more accurate your drawings will become. However, more lines will also mean more things to take note of, and it can be quite mind-boggling to look at so many guidelines. I start first with a very rough sketch of the front view of the character. I draw on one side, duplicate and flip it to form the other side. Once the rough drawing is done, I lower the opacity of that layer and create a new layer above it. I then proceed to draw the refined lines for the front view. Like the rough version, I am also drawing one half of the image, duplicating and flipping it later to save time. The line quality of the turnaround sheets do not have to be the cleanest. However, it should be clean enough to prevent any sort of ambiguity when the 3D modeler references it later on. To be honest, I find drawing turnaround sheets to be rather tedious, but with some practice, it can be churned out pretty rapidly. For this front view, I am placing my character in the A pose. The most ideal pose will be the T pose, as that will minimize any sort of muscle deformation for the 3D model. However, an A pose is still widely accepted, and it saves space on the canvas. Do draw the feet of the character standing roughly shoulder width apart. Placing the feet too close to one another will lead to complications in rigging and skinning later on in the 3D pipeline. We'll be right back. Once the overall drawing is done, I duplicated and flipped it. During this process, certain elements may look strange. In my case, the face became too white. This can be easily fixed by lassoing the region and transforming it again. Once the drawing has been duplicated and flipped, I can erase portions that are asymmetrical and draw these elements in. And with that, the front view is completed. With the completed front view as a reference, I start to block in the side view. Follow the guidelines you have set previously to ensure that the proportions are accurate. When drawing the side view, it is important to note the natural curves of the spine. You will also want to bend the knees slightly. This is to facilitate the rigging of the 3D model later on. You should separate the arm from the body in the side view. If you are drawing a T-pose for the front view, the arm should be drawn from the top view. The separation of the arm from the body is so that you do not cover most of the body's side profile with the arm. In my case, the arm of the character that I've designed is really, really long. So if I draw the arm together with the body, I think the 3D modeler will not be able to get any sort of meaningful data from the side profile of the body. With the initial blocking done, I created an empty layer above the rough sketch and drew the refined lines on it. When drawing the hands, try to keep the fingers open and far apart. Again, this will facilitate the rigging and skinning process later on in the 3D pipeline. Sometimes you will make adjustments to the proportions while drawing the character at a particular view. You need to then revisit the views that you have drawn previously to update the proportion changes if that happens, so that all the views match up nicely. The back view is easy once you have the front view up. Lower the opacity of the front view layer and use it as a reference. Block out the back view from there. Like the front view, you will only need to draw one side. Duplicate and flip the drawing to form the other side. Erase the asymmetrical parts and fill in those elements after that. To save time, I even duplicated the front view's arm. To do so, I used the lasso tool to select the arm in the front view layer. Go to Layer, New Layer via Copy. From there, I erased parts that are incorrect in the back view and just drew the correct version over it. I'm basing the arm around the standard human anatomy. So in the front view, you can see an armor plating that bears the shape of a bicep. In the back view, the armor is divided into three parts, like the human tricep. Integrating elements that draw reference from real-world sources will make your design more believable and functional. Thank you. all three views completed, I will round up the turnaround with a side view of the weapon. Depending on the design of your weapon, you may need to provide more views. For a blade like this though, I think the side view will suffice. I copied the blade from the 3/4 drawing and use it as reference for size and proportion. Ideally, I should be iterating on the blade design, but due to time constraint, I will just go with this one design. Alright, strictly speaking, in a production setting, we will have stopped at the previous step. But for the purpose of archival and presentation, you'll want to arrange and lay out your drawings in a more professional manner. I will show you some tricks to go about doing that. First, I create a new A3 canvas. I imported all the refined drawings that I've done into the new document. Next, I go to Google Images and I do a search for a LUT paper texture. I import that in and place it below the drawing layers. Next, I go to a font website like dafont.com and download a pirate looking font. With this font, I write down the character's name and the specifications of the assignment, which in this case is a boss character design, and I also include my name. You may also add in your 5W and 1H information about the character. After that, I lighten up the areas behind the drawings with a paintbrush, and I fill a color to highlight the drawings itself. To do so quickly, I select the line art drawing layer, use the magic wand tool to select the background, do a select inverse to invert the selection, and use the paint bucket tool to fill in the shape. I did a similar thing for the 3/4 view. I also added a shadow by duplicating the field shape, turning the shape into black by lowering the brightness with the hue saturation adjustment, and skewing the shape by hitting Ctrl T and adjusting the points while holding the Ctrl key. To fill up the rest of the empty space, I decided to do a close-up of the character's portrait. I also added in the character's pirate emblem. And with that, you have a portfolio-ready artwork of your original character with a turnaround view. There are no standard layouts for this sort of character sheets. You can include things like your 5W1H text information, character expressions, character actions and poses, and close-up views of the accessories that the character is holding. At the end of the day, the target that you should be aiming for is professional presentation of all these drawings and information. For the final task, based on the approved design, create a character turnaround on an A3 canvas. You may choose to insert any additional drawings such as a close-up on the face or the character during a pose.